in a bar in Toledo. Across from the depot, on a bar stool, she took off her ring. I thought I'd get closer, so I walked on over. I sat down and asked her name. When the drinks finally hit her, she said, "I'm no quitter, but I finally quit living on dreams. I'm hungry for laughter, and here ever after, I'm after whatever the other life brings." In the mirror I saw him, I closely watched him. I thought how they looked out of place. He came to the woman and sat down beside me. He had a strange look on his face. His big hands were calloused. He looked like a mountain. For a minute I thought I was dead. But he started shaking. His big heart was breaking. He turned to the woman and said, "You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. The poor hungry children are cropping the mill. I've had some bad times, but the soft times, but the time you're hurting won't heal. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille." After he left us, I ordered more whiskey. I thought how she made him look small. From the lights of the barroom to rented hotel room, we walked without talking at all. She was a cutie, and when she came to me, she must have thought I lost my mind. I couldn't hold her. The words that he told her kept coming back to me time after time. "You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille, with poor hungry children and a crop in the mill. I've had some bad times and been through some sad times, but this time you're hurting won't heal. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille, with poor hungry children and a crop in the field. I've had some bad times and lived through some sad times, but this time you're hurting won't heal. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. You picked a fine time to leave me."